Welcome, dear students. Happy Dashera, everyone, once again. And today we'll continue with the same text, unit number 11, from our textbook in English for class 9, Beehive. And the title of the text is If I Were You. We have discussed much about this text yesterday and also have watched some of the videos. Some students are still joining. Meanwhile, I would like to play a video for you all again. Those who could not enjoy yesterday, so please watch it carefully and try to understand the text. It's very simple to understand. It is in the form of, you know, play, drama it is. Okay? Would you like to watch?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Here it is.
If I Were You by Douglas James. If I Were You is a very interesting play with a very surprising end. The play is set in a small cottage in the wilds of Essex in which lives Gerard, a well-educated playwright. He's all set to go somewhere. While he is busy packing his bag, an intruder enters his cottage with a gun in his hand. Gerard welcomes him with confidence. Seeing Gerard to be a nonchalant, he points the gun at Gerard and threatens him.
Stop acting smart, man, or I will shoot you. Sit down there and listen to me.
The intruder informs him.
I'm being chased by the police and I have murdered a policeman.
He further says.
While I was in the town, I saw you and heard from people that you hardly meet anyone and order your things on phone. Since both of us are of the same height and build, I thought of a plan. I have come here to kill you and live on your identity in this peaceful cottage.
The intruder wants to know the details about Gerard before killing him so that he could imitate him well. He inquires about his car and the visitors who come to his house. Gerard is not at all afraid of the intruder and he very calmly answers all the questions in a nonchalant manner. He quickly conceives a false story to dodge the intruder and save his own life. He tells the intruder,
I too am a murderer, and the police have evidence against me. If you steal my identity, even then you would be chased by the police.
He further reveals,
I am carrying false mustaches so that I can disguise myself and hide from the police. Unfortunately, one of my men has been arrested and certain things are recovered, which my men should have burned. I sensed that the police could raid my house tonight. Therefore, I was packing my bag and was ready to escape. I have also positioned an accomplice on the road to warn me of any danger.
At that very moment, the phone rings and Gerard shouts.
The time has come to leave this place forever. Police can reach here anytime. You can come with me in my car.
He fools the intruder to believe him by saying,
If you feel that I am lying, you can kill me in the car.
The intruder doubts Gerard's story. So, Gerard asks him to peep out through the door of the garage to see the police for himself. In fact, the door is that of a cupboard. As the intruder bends forward, Gerard pushes him inside the cupboard and locks it. The intruder rattles the door from inside and shouts,
Get me out of here!
Gerard calls the sergeant in order to hand over the intruder to the police.
Enjoyed, dear students, and understood what is the story is about? Yes, dear students?
Yes, sir.
You got it,
yes,
well, sir. Everyone? Okay. Now, yes, dear Gayatri? You understood. Very good. Anybody want to say something? Can we proceed with the test? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So, if I were you, you may please watch the previous videos also. I'll share with you today a link. All of our lectures are available there on YouTube. And also another link I'll share you with about Google Drive, where you can download also all of these our lectures and replay as and when you want to watch. Right? Is it okay, everyone? Those who have
yes,
missed
sir.
One part or something, they will be able to watch them all again. Fine? So in the same, we understood how, you know, the scenario you is also in the video you have watched it, and there the conversation between Gerard and intruder is going on. Yesterday we are done with this part, that how, you know, the intruder entered and how Gerard, you know, responded him in such a funny way, showing some presence of mind just to distract his attention and get an opportunity to control him. That way he was trying to distract him, but finally, you know, they both sat down and the intruder wanted to ask him some questions so that he could know more about terror, and then he wanted to murder him by shooting with a gun and live like Gerard, taking on his identity. Okay. So all this that we studied yesterday, dear students, up to here. Now then we'll have a nice little talk about yourself. Who said? The intruder. Dear students, you also please read to the audio. The link has already been shared with you. This is very interesting audio that you can listen to and enjoy. And it will help you understand the text in detail very well. Fine? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Next, then what happens next after they sit down and how their communication, the conversation goes on. Gerard, at last, a sympathetic audience. You know, and Gerard is saying, at last, a sympathetic audience. He sat there and he is saying, sympathetic audience as whom do you think he is addressing as sympathetic audience? Yes, dear students. He has been very funny, you know, all the time since the intruder has entered there. Even if he is in gun, but Gerard has not scared. Even if he was afraid, but was trying to control his emotions and showing him as if he is not scared at all. And he simply called him, you know, hey, mister, what a surprise that you have entered. He did not got angry with him. Neither he himself showed any fear on his face. And now also he is making a pun, saying that at last, a sympathetic audience. Dear students, he addressed sympathetic audience as to intruder only. Saying that you are a good audience and you want to ask me something. It means I am going to say something and you are going to listen. Oh, great. That way he is making fun and trying to distract him. I'll tell you the story of my life. How, as a child, I was stolen by the gypsies. And why, at the age of 32, I find myself in my lonely Essex cottage? How? And you know, he is now again making a story and telling him that I was stolen away by the gypsies when I was just a little child, a little kid. And today, you know, I am 32 years old, that you can see. And I'm still finding myself here in this Essex cottage, whereas I was stolen when I was just a little kid. I will begin from there. As a little child to today, my age, that is 32. Understood, dear students? How old is Gerard? Can anyone tell what is his age?
32.
Yeah.
32.
Very good. And he began his story from his childhood. So do you think that he is telling the truth, that he was really stolen by the gypsies, or he is just making a story?
He is making a story.
Very good. And intruder also understood it. And that's why, what does he say? Let's listen to him. Keep it to yourself and just answer my questions. You live here alone. Well, do you? And he is now getting angry and saying, I don't want to know more about your childhood. I'm not here your audience, as you called me. But I just want my answers to the questions. That's it. And simply you listen to my question and answer. That's more than enough. I'm not here to listen to your story. I'm going to kill you. Listen now then, what happens? Gerard, I'm sorry. I thought you were telling me, not asking me. A question of inflection Your voice is unfamiliar. And then he says, as if you are telling me about yourself. And so, you know, I misunderstood it. Okay, I'm sorry. I thought you were telling me, not asking. Okay, so ask your question. What is your first question? And that way he's saying, and the conversation goes on. The intruder says, am I audible to your students?
Yes, sir.
Hello? Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
So that way he asked the first question. And what is the first question? You live here alone? Well, do you? And that way he asked the question. And then what did he say? That you are telling that you are living alone and not asking. Anyway, I got that this is your question. Intruder repeated again with emphasis. Do you live here alone? Jared says. And if I don't answer, then he, you know, this way he's just trying to distract and get angry so that there should be, you know, a time, an opportunity for Jared that he should be able to control him, and somewhere he will be able to manage and go away from there, escape from the intruder. And so he says, and if I don't answer, intruder, you have got enough sense not to want to get hurt. And he is now pointing out the gun. Can you see? There is a gun in my hand. And I think you are smart enough. You have that much of sense that what may happen if you don't answer. Jared says, I think good sense is shown mere in the ability to avoid pain than in the mere desire to do so. What do you think, mister? And there he says, I think good sense is shown mere more in the ability to avoid pain than in the mere desire to do so. And there is not good sense to bear the pain, but there is a good sense in avoiding it. And that's what he says, and says, what do you think? What's your opinion, mister? And there, Gerard is trying to show much interest in knowing his name. He did not ask him directly, but saying, mister, and that way he expects that the intruder should tell his name. But did he? Let's see. Intruder says, never mind my name. I like yours better, Mr. Gerard. What are your Christian names? And then he, instead of telling his own name, is asking his name. Even if he is just knowing about Mr. Gerard, but he is not known about his real name as per his identity. And so intruder asked him about his Christian name, his full name, the proper name that is there. We have different pet names, some friends give us some other names, but they are not our Christian name. Like, you know, in previous lesson, Bond of Love, there is a sentence that author's wife Christian him Bruno. So Christian him Bruno means he gave him the name as Bruno. Like that, Gerard was also Christian, means was named. And what was his real name? That Gerard says, Vincent Charles. What did he say his name as? Vincent Charles. Intruder says, do you run a car? Gerard, no. Now he's answering properly. Intruder, that's a lie. You are not dealing with a fool. I'm as smart as you and smarter. And I know you run a car. Better be careful, wise guy. And that time, you know, the next question was about running the car. And Gerard says, no. But the intruder was already knowing that Gerard knows driving. He could run a car, and that was the reason that there was a car outside and with a bag. He was just about to move from there, and he had mentioned that on the way you can ask me a question and the policemen are there and I'm also a criminal, right? And so the intruder was already knowing that he was knowing, you know, he knows and he can run a car. But the intruder then listened his answer saying no and got angry. And then he said, you are not dealing with a fool. I am not a fool that you are telling me that you don't know driving. I know you are running a car. And I am as smart as you. And moreover, I am smarter than you. I know you run a car. Better be careful, wise guy. Don't answer me in a wrong way. Be proper in your answers. Can't you see a gun in my hand? I am going to shoot you down. Fine? So be careful and answer my questions very well. That way, you know, the conversation, you can imagine that must be going on between them. What happened next? Let's see. Gerard says, are you American or is that merely a clever imitation? And then another question. Instead of the intruder asked, Gerard is only telling and asking him. And are you American or you are just speaking like you are an American? You know, dear students, this incident and the play is based on American language. Because in the activity before you read, we have found some of the words that they are using American English only. And there are short, but more differences are there between British and American English. In India, we are following British English. Like color, the spelling of color in American English is C-O-L-O-R. But in British English, it is C-O-L-O-U-R. There are such many examples. Are you getting there, students? Understanding everyone?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So let's see then what happens next. Did really intruder shoot him with the gun or something goes wrong? You know everything in the video we have watched, but let's see in detail how it happened. That's really interesting. Intruder, listen, this gun's no toy. I can hurt you without killing you and still get my answers. You are asking me only the questions? If I am American, that is none of your business. You just answer my questions. This gun, this is not a toy. I'm going to hurt you. I'm not going to kill you first, but I'm going to hurt you first and then I'll get my answers. Do you want me to hurt you? Don't you want to avoid your pain? What does Gerard say? Of course, if you put it like that, I'll be glad to assist you. I do possess a car and it's in the garage around the corner. And then now, you know, he just puts a gun aside and Gerard is also a little happy that he has put the gun aside and is now very happy to assist him. But he is just pretending to a student. He doesn't want, but he just wants to distract the intruder so that he can manage to escape from there somewhere or catch the intruder and put him somewhere. How he did that, you are known, but let's see how he did that way. So intruder, that's better. Do people often come out here? Now he is answering well and the intruder is also happy that he is telling the truth. And another next question he asked, do people often come out here? Is there anybody, your relative, somebody, those who come here every now and then to see you, to meet you? Gerard says, very rarely. Surprisingly, few people take the trouble to visit me. There is the baker and the greengrocer, of course. And then there is the milkman, quite charming, but no one so interesting as yourself. And you know, he is again making a fun. No, there are no people coming and meeting me. But of course, there are some people, you know, the baker, the greengrocer, because they have to come. Baker with some bread, greengrocer with some grocery, you know, those things to supply him. Milkman, of course, coming there every day. But none of them showed any interest in knowing more about me. But you are the first one. So interesting. Who wants to know everything about me? Anyway, next question. And that way, you know, he is making fun. Intruder, I happen to know that you never see tradespeople. And then the next question he asks about the tradespeople, but telling himself that he has come to know that, you know, Gerard never goes out and see the tradespeople, it's the merchants. Gerard, you seem to have taken a considerable amount of trouble since you know so much about me. Won't you say something about yourself? You have been so modest. And Gerard is telling no answer here again, but making fun another way. How? He's saying, oh, good man, I don't know your name, but you have taken much efforts, you know, to know and collect information about me. Very good. Nobody had ever taken any more efforts, you know, to know about me, but you have. Really, you are so interested in me. That's a great. But please share something about you. Won't you say something about yourself? You have been so modest. You have been so humble, dear. So tell me about something. Yourself also? Then what did the intruder say? I could tell you plenty. You think you are smart, but I am the top of the class around here. I have got brains and I use them. That's how I have got where I have. And you know, finally he says, who you are? I am going to tell you there are so many things that I can share. But do you think I'll share with you? No, don't be smart. I am the top one criminal and I am having brains with me. And I am using them. I'm not like you. And here, you know, because of that, I have got such a position that I have done these many crimes and still the policemen are not able to catch me. So you don't ask about me. You got it, dear? That's how I have got where I have. And I'm not going to share with you, even if there are so many things that I can share. Then what does the another character Gerard say? And where precisely have you got? It didn't require a great brain to break into my little cottage. And you know, he is again making fun that where precisely have you got? You are saying you have brain, and but it doesn't prove that you have many brains and that you are using, because just breaking the window and entering in my house, it doesn't need, it doesn't require great brain. And he is again that way getting on him and trying to trouble, trying to distract. Is he successful in that? Let's see. The intruder says, when you know why I have broken into a little cottage, you will be surprised, and it won't be a pleasant surprise. Okay, you know that I have entered by breaking your window in your cottage and have entered. You will be more surprised, you know, when you will come to know that why have I come here for. You will be really surprised, and that is not just a pleasant surprise, but it will be a shocking, really a surprise for you, and you will be shocked to listen to me if I share with you why I am.
Dear students, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Is my voice clear to everyone? Well?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. There is a network problem, so I was, you know, out of the meeting. So, what are we done with your students? About jewelry and he's a robber of jewels. Did it done? Did you hear it that much?
No, sir. No.
What was the last point that I was sharing with you? Could you hear it?
So that you have been so modest.
Oh, you have been so modest. After that, you got nothing.
No, sir. The pleasant surprise.
Pleasant surprise, you got it.
Yes, sir.
But about jewelry, he did. You could not get it. He told something
no,
about
sir.
Jewelry.
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Am I audible, dear students? Well, now is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. You please tell me when I'm not audible so that we can proceed. I think a paragraph or two, I just went on speaking, but there was a network problem and so you could not get. Anyway, so about after pleasant surprise, I'll start with. Gerard says, with you figuring so largely in it, that is understandable. By the way, what particular line of crime do you embrace or aren't you a specialist? And there he says, Gerard, that if you are just a criminal, that you just rob some of the things, or you are specialist like sharpshooter or something like that. Then intruder says, my specialty is jewel robbery. Means he is good at robbing the jewelry shops and the jewelry. And he also adds that your car will do me a treat and it's certainly a dandy bus. And he also adds that your car that is there outside is really going to be very useful for me. In what sense? Because easily I can rob the jewelry and put it in the car and immediately I will go away from there and come back to this remote place where the policeman won't be able, you know, to catch me. Then Gerard says, I'm afraid jewels are few and far between the wilds of Essex. And he says that there are few jewels here, but they are far between in the wilds of Essex. Means that place is the wilds of Essex where there are no more jewels because the people are only living in a very less density. And intruders then says, so are the cops. But that is also beneficial in another way. How? Because the policemen are also not coming here in this area. They are far away from there. So I can easily, you know, rob the jewelry from there, from the cities, from the towns where there are more people living and there are the jewelry shops. And I can retire here nicely for a little while. And I'll easily come to this place and live here happily myself and spend much time being here. Then Gerard is getting some idea. You mean to live with me? A trifle sudden, isn't it? You have not been invited. And there Gerard says that you mean to live with me here? No, but you are not invited. It may not be possible that you are living with me here in this place. Then the intruder says, you won't be here long. So I didn't trouble to ask. And hey, Mr. Gerard, you won't be here anymore. And so I did not trouble at all to ask you who you are. You know, I'm not going to ask you and I'm going to live here alone. Then Gerard says, what do you mean? He was surprised because how is it possible? He's saying that I'm not going to live here and he's only, what does he mean? And so he asked intruder, what do you mean? Then the intruder tells him everything, what he had come here for. This is your big surprise. I'm going to kill you. And there the intruder told him the fact that he had been there to kill him. And after he kills him, Gerard is of course nowhere.
Sir, you're not audible.
Am I audible to your students?
Yes, sir.
So, you understood what was he there for?
Yes, sir.
What was the reason? Can you please share? What does the intruder mean that he is going to live there and not Mr. Gerard? What does he mean?
Means he is going to kill Jaren.
Very good. So that I explained. You got it, everyone? Were you able to listen to me? Keep responding, I'm facing network issue, dear student. I'm really sorry. So I'm getting disconnected meanwhile. Or shall we end and continue tomorrow? You tell me. Am I well audible and you are getting me?
Yes, sir.
Sir, but your voice is breaking in between.
Yes, sir.
Voice is breaking in between. Anyway, then we'll continue tomorrow. Once again, dear students, happy Dashera. Thank you so much. Have a great day ahead. Take care, dear students. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. I will find, all of our videos of the previous sessions, right from the first lecture to today's lecture. You will get all our videos available there. And you will be able to watch on YouTube. And also, you can download from another link from Google Drive. That also I'm going to share with you. Fine? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
We have missed, can replay those videos and can study in a better way. Okay, thank you so much, dear students. Once again, happy Dashera. Bye. Take care.